雪般发送，雪般发送
，Savior of a song， Lover of a song，
We are on the wrong side， We will never give up。
Exalt your name, we magnify you because you're a wonderful Father, King of kings, Lord of lords. Who can speak your word if you have not given order, if your spirit is not in? Jesus, I ask for mercy wherever I've sinned against you, wherever I've erred against thee, or make you not to use me tonight. Jesus, have mercy upon me, and wherever your children have erred against thee, I will make you not to allow your word to come into them. Have mercy. Come and teach us. Come and have your way. Holy Ghost, come and take your place. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As your daughter have led today, that we should also pray that we'll be able to live undiluted life as we are hearing undiluted word. Father, after tonight, we are on this mountain shall be living on undiluted life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Abba Father, because I know you have done it. Use me again to your glory alone. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Satan, I expel you out of our midst right now. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, tonight we have a message, Bible study message titled Some Causes of Backsliding. Some Causes of Backsliding. I wouldn't say causes of backsliding because there are other causes that might not be outlined here that are also there. But the ones that are here are the ones who hear tonight some causes of backsliding. Tonight, we all will be together, read the Bible together, and I pray the Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. So therefore, I want to quickly do it this way before we kick off. I would like, Stego, please go and hang on in Matthew chapter 12, verse 30. Tego, please, just hang on there. Bro, please, hang on in James chapter 4, verse 4. Hang on there, bro, please. Bro Fred, hang on in Revelation 3, verse 16. Revelation 3, 16. Sister Pat, isn't it? Hang on in Dr. Solomon, chapter 2, verse 15. Please, Mr. Mark, everybody, when I mention your Bible passage, you read it out. Sister Ezekiel, please, everybody, mute your mic, please. Sister Ezekiel, hang on in Hebrews, chapter 10, verse 26. Please, don't forget your own, and don't remember to call your name again. Sister Adewumi, James 4:17. Sister Adewumi, James 4:17, from Matthew Obadari. 2 Samuel 11, verse 1. 2 Samuel 11, verse 1. Sister Edith Joshua, Genesis chapter 3, verse 17. Genesis 3, 17. Okay, Sister Gloria Okegwale, Ephesians chapter 4, verse 27 to 28. Sister Gloria, Ephesians 4, 27 to 28. Praise the Lord. Sister Taya Gordon, Genesis chapter 13, verse 19. Genesis 13, 19. Sister Okaka, Atonia, Genesis, Genesis 19:29. I want to read everybody tonight. Please, everybody, meet your mic. I beg you, please. Sister Jennifer. Colossians chapter 3, verse 1 to 2. Sister Jennifer, Colossians 3, 1 to 2. Sister Hesiva Onka, 2 Timothy 4, verse 10. 2 Timothy 4, verse 10. When we get there, we'll start from there again. We have a lot to read tonight. The Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Tonight, as I've said before, the topic is some causes of backsliding. We know what is backsliding. When somebody was fervent in doing the work of God, and gradually the person will be drawing back, and before you know it, somebody who used to preach before or doing whatever he was doing before, he will stop doing it. Backsliding stops gradually. It stops from a point. And tonight, we're going to be outlining some causes of such thing. And we know people who are backsliding, they are very sharp in their mouth. They are full of themselves, mostly. When you tell them you are backsliding, they will tell you, I know what I'm doing. I am whom I am. I am not backsliding. I am comfortable. I am okay. Don't worry about me. Mostly, people who are in a backsliding state are always full of themselves. They are most times very hard to talk to. I am okay, Mr. Man. My sister, don't worry. I still study the Word of God. I am just okay, just like the Bible told us in Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 11. Say, and the Lord said unto me, the backsliding Israel hath justified herself more than the treacherous Judah. People who are backsliding, who are falling away, they always learn to justify themselves. First word they say is, I know what I'm doing. I am just okay. I'm even talking about you. You are even the one falling if you don't know. If somebody is talking that way, please do something about that person to make sure you go into prayer with that person. And your eye is seeing that this person is going down. You are no more the person I used to know before, but he'll be telling you, I'm just okay. I'm fine. I still study. I'm still connecting sometimes. And this person used to be very fervent. Yeah, I still connect sometimes. Know that person is going down. So we're going to be outlining what causes backsliding. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As I said before, I'm not preaching. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 some causes of backsliding. Number one here is deception of neutrality. Deception of neutrality. Sometimes some people who were very fervent in doing the work of God, who knew what sin is, all of a sudden they will start saying, let me measure, let me stay at the center. trying to balance between the world and God, trying to stay at the fence. Deception of neutrality. Don't talk about those men of God. And don't talk about sin. The Bible, this person used to be very eloquent before when he's talking about sin. Don't judge these people. And the Bible says don't judge. Just try to maintain your, just be, maintain yourself. Trying to be neutral. When you see somebody who was very hard in sin before, they condemn sin, they nail the head, the nail to the head. They call spade a spade, not just a farm tool. All of a sudden, the person is not calling, and they are all off everything, all the farm, this thing, they are the same. I'm doing this because of the network. Deception of neutrality. Either we move, I read as it, as I write it here, either we move forward with God or we move backward. There is no neutral ground. There is no standing, no sitting on the fence. Jesus says we must either be for him or against him. Matthew 12:30. Matthew 12:30.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Matthew 12:30. I read, he that is not with me is against me, and he that gathereth not with me scattereth abroad. Amen.
Amen. The Lord Jesus Christ said, you cannot be, it's either you are hitting sin on the head or you are living in sin yourself. There is no standing between the fence. When somebody is not trying to stand between the fence, know that that person is going down. Jesus Christ is telling us here, it's either you are against sin or you are living in sin. And as I wrote here, just make it clearer. At James, make it clear that any friendship with the world makes the Christian the enemy of God. James 4:4.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
James 4:4, I read in Jesus' name. Ye adulterers, ye adulteresses, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with God? Was whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is the enemy of God. Amen.
Amen. So it's either you are the friend of the world, you are against God, or you are with God against the world. God says, of those who are lukewarm, I will spew them. I will spew the out of my mouth. It's either you are hurt or you are cold. If you are lukewarm, if you are not hot nor cold, that means you are of the world. You are backsliding. According to Revelation 3:16, those who try to ride the fence are actually in a backsliding state. Those who try to ride the fence. The Lord is on the other side. While the world is on the other side, you are trying to ride the fence. You are actually on a backsliding phase, on a backsliding state. It's either you are hot for Jesus or you are hot for the world. There is no room for coldness. There's no room for standing on the fence. So when you see yourself not trying to sit on the fence, know that the spirit of deception of neutrality is working on you. Number two, little compromises. Little compromises. The book of Song of Solomon reveals that it is the little forces that destroy the vines. It is the little forces that destroy the vine. You that see sin before you tackle it, gradually you are not commonized on sin. You are not allowed of sin to come into you. You that will see sin from a distance, you'll be pursuing it. But now, you see yourself condoling some. Sister, brother, you are backsliding. So, he says, a drop of water falling on a rock every second or every 5 seconds appear to have little or no effect, of no effect, a few hours of it. But let that same drop of water continue to fall day after day, night after night, week after week, month after month. You will see the rock getting weaker and weaker. The rock will erode away. That little sin you are aligned to come to your life, you can still pray now. You can still do, you can still connect. A time is coming, that little sin will disconnect you. That little sin will stop you from praying. So if you find out that you now allow some sin in your life, you better do something about it, because you are backsliding. According to Songs of Solomon, chapter 2, verse 15. Please, if you are there, read it fast. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
I put somebody there today.
Sister Pat Ididi is the one
saying. Please, please read.
Songs of Solomon 2:15, I read, take us the forces and the little forces that spoil the vines, for our vines have tender grapes. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Little forces spoil the vine. As I've illustrated, if you allow little drop of water to be hidden on the rock, if you call after 1 hour, you may not see any effect. Maybe you may even call after 6 months, you don't see any effect. But if you allow it to continue to hit it little by little, every day, every year, a time is coming, you see the rock will be dissolved. That is what sin can do. God allow little sin into your life. A time is coming, that little sin you allow become a very mighty ocean in your life, and it will draw you out of the word of God. When Christians neglect Bible reading, prayer, church attendance, and give in to little sin, it's only a matter of time before their spiritual life will erode away. When we stop connecting, before when the time is coming, you are always there before time. A time will not come, you connect after 5 minutes. You connect after 10 minutes. You are gradually eroding away. A time is coming, you just drop out. A time is coming, you cannot pray anymore. Sister, you are going down, down, down. Brother, you are going down, down, down. So let us not allow little sin to come into our life. Little compromises. When you compromise of sin, you that hate all sin before, you're not compromising. You are going down. The Bible told us, I will read this one. The Bible told us in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 26. For if we sin willfully, after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, there remains no more sacrifice for sin. Those things you used to hate before, you are now loving them gradually. You are going down. You are backsliding. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
17 told us there, therefore, if to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, it is a sin. Before, you know that connecting late to the mountain is a sin you used to fear before. Even when you connect late, you could be like, hey, I am very sorry. But now, even if you connect 30 minutes late, you don't care anymore. Sister, brother, you are falling. Before, when you don't do worship, you'll be crying, hey, I have not done worship today, I have not prayed today. But now, even if you don't do it for 5 days or 6 days, you don't care again. Sister, brother, you are in a backsliding state if you are not backslided already. And I pray as many of all that in that state, the Lord will deliver us all in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Next one, number three, is neglect of responsibilities. Neglect of responsibilities. Like we are on this mountain, we know what the Lord has given us the power to be doing. Some of all those introduction, and we are doing, you see joy in your heart doing it. But a time is coming, maybe pride will not come into your life. One thing or the other was used to give you joy before. You don't like doing it again. You are falling. Now, I give an illustration here. David's time of backsliding started when he neglected the duties God had given him. Idleness is the devil's playground. The Bible recorded that when he fell into lust and immorality with Bathsheba, it was a time when kings go for the battle. The time that David fell into the sin of immorality, into the sin of fornication, into the sin of adultery, of killing, it was the time when the kings go to battle. According to 2 Samuel chapter 2, chapter 11, verse 1. 2 Samuel 11, verse 1. If I give you, please quickly read it.
Brother Matthew.
Praise the Lord. It says, and it came to pass, after the year was expired, at a time when kings go forth to battle, that David sent Joab and his servants with him, and all Israel, and he destroyed the children of Ammon, and beside Rabbah, but David tarried still at Jerusalem.
Amen. And if you are a good Bible reader, if you read further, you will see that that was the time David fell. This was the time that the kings go for battle. But now David is not settled. He's no more in the cave Adullam anymore. The Lord has elevated him out of the cave. He's not a king. Now he's not relinquishing his duty to other people. What have you been doing that used to give you joy? You are not seeing, they are not giving other people. You don't care about it. Sister, brother, you are falling. You are gradually leaving the way of the Lord. The time that he fell down was the time that the king, he was supposed to be at the war front. But he relaxed and devil worked on him to see a woman bathing. At that time, you are supposed to be praying. You are not praying. Satan will manifest himself in you. At that time, you are supposed to be doing one thing or the other that you used to do before. For the Lord, you are no more doing it. You are going down. God's requirement of labor and hard work for man to eat where for man's benefit and to deter him from evil. When God calls the ground, He added for your sake in Genesis chapter 3, verse 17. With the Genesis 3, 17.
Sister Edith.
Please praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Please, Brother Peace and Brother Fred, if you can follow me, please, I'll be very, very happy.
Amen.
That's not good. Just forget it. I go to sleep.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. And unto Adam he said, because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of the wife, and hast eaten of the tree of which I commanded thee, saying, thou shalt not eat, cannot eat of it. Cursed is the ground for the sake. In sorrow shalt thou eat of it all the day of the life. Amen.
So the Lord pronounced curse in the land for your sake. In that Genesis chapter 3, verse 14. A man who keep busy with God giving responsibility will be less likely to give place to Satan in his life. A man who is always busy, looking for the next thing to do. Hey, I have to do this for the Lord. Hey, keep yourself busy. It will be very hard for Satan to be able to burrow inside of you and start manipulating you. It's when you are idle. It's when you are not doing anything. You are just sitting down. You know it, some thought will be coming. If you know it, that thought will magnify into you and you start backsliding. So therefore, let's keep ourselves busy. Praise Master Jesus. Amen. Amen. Ephesians chapter 4, 27 to 28.
Praise the Lord. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 27 to 28. I read in Jesus' name. Neither give place to the devil. 28. let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the things which is good, that he may give, that he may have to give to him that needed. Amen.
Amen. Give no place to the devil. Let him that is idle be idle no more. Let him that stole steal no more. The reason why you are stealing is because you have no work to be doing in the house of the Lord. It's because you are not doing anything for the Lord. I told us one time when I went to evangelism, I saw some guys fighting. And as they were fighting, I was evangelizing. I said in my heart, oh God, if these people have work to do now, they will not be fighting here. And all of a sudden, I was surprised. They stopped fighting and rushed to me. I told me, please give us tracks to share. I gave them tracks. They shared everything. Come again. All the tracks I carried that day, they finished up. That is that's why it is very good to engage ourselves in working for the Lord. If you don't want the devil to pull you out of the race, out of the heavenly race, engage yourself in the work of God. That's why on this mountain we try to make sure everybody has done something. When you remember that I do read Bible before the time, you try to connect because you are coming to work for the Lord. So therefore, in our homes out there, let us try to engage ourselves in the work of the Lord. And when the Lord has given you a duty, please make sure you hold on to it. Do it as if it's your life. Don't be like Brother David, who neglected his duty and relinquished it to somebody else. But you know, he backslid that and fell down. And I pray the Lord will help us all in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise Master Jesus. Number four. Temporal values. Temporal value. You value the things of this world. If you are somebody, before you don't love the things of this world, all these things don't freak you. And now you are gradually loving them. Those things that don't move you before, now you are gradually putting your heart in them. Know that you are in a backsliding state. Know that you are gradually going down. If you don't do something about it, you might fall. Temporary values. Now, Lot is a tragic example of the believers who backslided into major sin. I come again. Lot, we all know the story of Lot in the Bible, is a tragic example of the believer who backslid into major sin. Genesis chapter 13, verse 19. Genesis 13, verse 19.
19:29. And it came to pass when God destroyed the city of the plan, and God remembered Abraham and sent Lot out of the midst of the overthrow, when he overthrew the city in which Lot dwelt. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I missed something there. What I am trying to explain here is, now, I come again. Lot is a tragic example of the believers who backslided into major sin. The only reason Lot was spared the wrath of God when judgment fell upon Sodom and Gomorrah was because of Abraham's prayer. Lot's trouble started when he chose the plain that was well watered. Lord loved the temporary value of the things of this world. When Abraham asked him, choose, he chose the playground already made ground. You that don't want to labor, you don't fast and pray. You need, I call them microwave Christianity. You don't want any stress. You want everything just to be good for you at all time. You don't pray. You don't study. You are just easy going. My sister, my brother, you will easily go down if care is not taken. This was what happened to our brother, Abraham Lot. If you read Genesis 13, 11.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Genesis 13, 11, I read, then Lot chose him all the plain of Jordan, and Lot journeyed east, and they separated themselves the one from the other. Amen.
Hallelujah. That is exactly where I was talking about. Rather than having his mind on the things above, he valued material treasure greater than the spiritual treasure. His mind was set on the things below. Colossians 3, 1 to 2. Colossians 3, 1 to 2. Please, if you are there, you can read there.
I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sits on the right hand of God. Verse 2. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. Amen.
Amen. If you now found out that all your mind is not on materialistic things of this world, know that you are going down. You are backsliding. All you are thinking about, all your prayer point is on material things. Father, I need a car. Father, I need a house. Father, I need a job. Father, I need documents. You are not concerned about your spiritual well-being. You are not concerned about where you will dwell in eternity. Sister, you are backsliding. Maybe before now, it was not so. You never prayed about these things before. But now, you are not concentrating on them the most. You are backsliding as our brother Lot. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Demas forsook Paul and God because he loved the present world, according to 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 10. 2 Timothy 4, verse 10.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
2 Timothy 4, 10. For Demas, in love with this present world, had deserted me and go to Thessalonica, Christians, has gone to Galatia.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
What our brother, Paul, talking here. Said Demas, because he have loved the presence of this world, have forsaken me, have gone away. What I've also made to forsake God now. You used to be very fervent before. You used to always be with us. Because of your marriage now, because of your car or whatsoever, you don't look at connect again. You don't study the word of God. You are as good as Brother Demas in hell if you don't repent. So, if you don't want to fall and go to hell, you better wake up now. Don't allow the temporary things of this world to make you go out of the way of God. And the Lord will help us all in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number 5. Neglect of separation from the world. Neglect of separation from the world. The Lord will always tell his children, be ye separate. Don't go with them. Be ye separate from a repentant sinner. My children, don't mingle yourself with the world. But you tell yourself, I'm a wise man. I know how to maintain my own. I'm just following them. I am not doing it with them. The Lord is telling you today, if you keep following them, you will go the way they are going. Neglect of separation from the world. A second step in Lot's backsliding was that he pitched his tent towards Sodom. Lot pitched his tent towards Sodom. Sodom is worldly. Sodom is a state that is full of immorality. And our brother, a man of God, pitched his tent in Sodom. not like some Christians want to see how close he could live to the world and not get hurt. It's not possible. You cannot enter into a burning fire and not get burned. You cannot dip your hand into a burning oil and you will not get burned. You cannot gallivant with the people of the world. You are saying you are free from sin. It's not possible. You will one day go down with them. That was what happened to our brother, bro Lot. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Christians are to be in the world, but not of the world. According to John chapter 17, verse 15, that says, I pray not that thou should take them out of the world, but that thou should keep them from the evil. Keep yourself from the evil in the world. The reason why you must go with them is to preach the message for them. The reason why the Lord Joshua was praying this prayer is that the apostle, I'm leaving them in the world, so that through them, the people will come out of the world, not to start eating and drinking with them. Some of us, maybe some of us that go to school now, like as I'm in the language school, I want to make myself to be like them. After closing, we start drinking mineral and doing all this thing together. It's not supposed to be so. The reason why I'm there is to school. After school, if I must talk to them, it's about the word of God. Trying to make friends with them and would be endangering my salvation. So therefore, don't try to gallivant with the people of the world. The Bible told us in Psalms chapter 1. Psalms chapter 1, please, if you are there. Psalms chapter 1, verse 1. Please read it, Brother Matthew or Brother Peace, if you are there.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Amen.
Amen. Blessed is the man that standeth not in the way of sinners. The Christians are not to walk in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stand in the way of sinners. Praise Master Jesus. Let us do everything possible to make sure we give gap to the people of the world. Make sure you give gap to them. The more they get closer to you, the more they are influencing you. I always tell us on this mountain, it's easier to drop somebody on the top of a ladder down than he that is there. It's easier for he that is down to draw you that is up down than for you to pull him up. Those people of the world, they are down. You are up there. If you are not careful, they don't need to use more pressure just to draw it a little bit. You see yourself on the ground. So therefore, let us do everything to run far. The only reason why we should meet with them is when we want to share the word of God. After sharing it, we draw again. The Bible told us in Proverbs once. Can a man take fire in his bosom and not be burnt? Neither can a Christian have close associates with the world and still keep himself unspotted by the world. It's not possible. James chapter 1, verse 27. James 1, 27. I took God, please, to follow me just now so that it can be legal.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I read James 1:27. Pure religion, undefiled before God and the Father, is this: to visit the fatherless and widow in their afflictions, and to keep himself unspotted from the world. Praise the Lord.
Jesus. To keep himself unspotted from the world. The best way to do this is to give God to the world. If you go to market with your big and bad cloth and where they are selling oil, you are thinking you will be so careful not to rub yourself with oil. If you don't rub it to yourself, the daughter or the child of the woman selling oil will help you to rub it. So therefore, we must be careful the way we mingle ourselves with the churches of the world. We have churches who are of the world, with the people of the world, so that they will not draw you out of the way of God. Remember, the Lord Jesus said, I am coming back for a deathless church. a stainless church, for you not to be found stained on that day, run away from the things and the people of the world. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Remember, I told us I'm not preaching. If I was preaching, I would have not been reading everything, preaching it, but I have to. I am trying to do it gently so that we all will understand. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Number six, reformation without transformation. Reformation without transformation can make somebody to backslide and fall down. What do I mean? When somebody, maybe you deliver somebody now from a demon, that place that the demon go away from, if you don't fill it with another spirit of God, sooner than later, that demon will come back there again. If you are reformed, you are not transformed, before you know it, you'll be deformed again. Now, a believer who dedicates himself to fully serve God must not only separate himself from the ungodliness and worldliness around him, but must also make sure he replaces these things with God's righteousness. I come again. A believer who dedicates himself to fully serve God must not only separate himself from the ungodliness and worldliness around him, but also make sure he replaces these things with God's righteousness and holiness. Titus chapter 2, verse 12.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Titus chapter 2, verse 12, I read, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. Amen.
Amen. Now, for instance, the believer who stopped listening to the worldly music must replace in his life harmonious music that pleases God. When you were in the world, you used to love music that they call it rock and roll, kill and die. Now that you don't listen to them again, replace them with the songs of God, with the word of God. Don't leave that place empty. If you leave it empty, before you know it, Satan will gradually come in there again. I pray you understand me in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
I come again. For instance, the believer who stopped listening to worldly music must replace in his life harmonious music that pleases God. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1, verse 18.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Ephesians chapter 5, verse 18. I read. It says, be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Do not drunk with wine. As you are no more drinking alcohol, that intoxication that intoxicates you with alcohol when you're in the world. Don't just say, I don't drink alcohol again, just leave yourself bazaar like that. Now, fill it with Holy Ghost. Fill that place with Holy Ghost now. Let the Holy Ghost be the one moving you now. I don't, before, you can't stay without, you know, drink, be drunk, and you are, they call it, they make themselves happy. Now that you are now born again, don't be cold. Let the Holy Ghost fill that space of alcohol. If the Holy Ghost is not there, alcohol is no more there, a time is coming, alcohol will come back again. The only reason why you will be able, the only way why you will be able to sustain your Christian life as not drinking alcohol again is when the Holy Spirit have not filled that place. I pray God will grant us understanding in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, a godly friend must be replaced with Christian friendship. Ungodly friends must be replaced with Christian friendship. Psalm chapter 1, verse 1 to 2, 3, we read it before. Proverbs 13, verse 20. Father, you read it.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Proverbs 13, verse 20, I read, he that walketh with wise men shall be wise, but a companion of fools shall be destroyed. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
The world, you to walk with fools. Now you are no more with them. Look for wise people to replace the foolish people with. You cannot just say, okay, I'm alone now. I'm no more with wise people. I'm no more with foolish people. You are not also with wise. You are just neutral. Satan will come into your life again. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Before you backslid, you will not know. The man who removed the unclean spirit in Matthew chapter 12, please, we're going to read this because of time. Matthew 12, 43 to 45, still had an empty house. He had reformed this life. He had reformed. But if you don't transform it by replacing that empty space with the Holy Ghost, the demons will come back again. Please, just read it because of time. Understanding. Matthew 12, 43 to 45.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Matthew 12, 43 to 45, I read in Jesus' name. When the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, he walketh through dry places, seeking rest, and findeth none. Verse 44, then he said, I will return into my house from where I cometh out. And when he's come, he findeth it empty, swept and garnished. 45, then goeth he and taketh with him, he taketh with himself seven other spirits more wicked than himself. And they enter in and dwell there. And the last state of that man is worse than the first. Even so shall it be also unto this wicked generation. Amen.
Amen. So therefore, don't leave that space empty. As I read here, the man who removed the unclean spirit still had an empty house. He had reformed his life, but had not been transformed by the power of God. Consequently, the same unclean spirit returned with seven other spirits more wicked. The last state of that man is worse than the first, according to Matthew 12, verse 45. He had taken out the unclean spirit, but had replaced it with the clean spirit. That's why it's very, very advisable if you go into deliverance. Make sure you do everything to replace that place in your life that those unclean spirits run away from. Make sure you invite the Holy Spirit to come and fill it. That's why I pity some people who go to TB Joshua and other churches to go and do deliverance. You go to one church in London or soever, they do deliverance upon you, I don't know, and they leave you like that. No word of God every day to your life. I'm telling you, that place is open. Before you know it, those deliverance that was done in Lagos or in wherever, those demons, they know that place is empty now. Nothing is in there. If you don't invite the Holy Spirit through the Word of God into that place, they are coming again. Before you know it, you will fall back to the state of sin again. So therefore, It is advice for you and I. Let us not leave our space empty. It must be filled with the Holy Ghost. So therefore, what do we do? Let us be drawn to the place of hearing the Word of God at all time. Undiluted Word of God. And let us learn to pray at all time. Holy Ghost, fill me. Every empty space in my life, fill it. Whenever we come for Friday deliverance, after then, learn to pray. Father, I know something have left me. Let something new, a bad spirit have gone away. Let the clean spirit of God come into me. That's why when the Lord took away his spirit from Saul, he not leave Saul empty. But say, the clean spirit of God left Saul. And unclean spirit came upon Saul. So therefore, nobody is empty. Whenever you see an empty space in your life, before Satan will come and fall you down, quickly ask Lord to fill you again. I pray God grant us understanding tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. The next one is neglect of the godly fellowship. Neglect of the godly fellowship. Christians are commanded to meet together on a regular basis for worship, fellowship, prayer, ministry of the word of God, not for gossiping. We are advised. That's why we try to make sure we wake up into the presence of God on this mountain every day. So that day will be filled with the word of God. It is very, very imperative that Christians meet together to fellowship together, to worship together, to pray together, and to minister the word of God together. Mutual exhortation and communion. Acts chapter 2, verse 42. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25. The prayer, Hebrews 10, 25.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Acts, Hebrews, yes.
Hebrews 10, 25.
Acts chapter 2, verse 42. I read. And they continue steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, in breaking of bread and in prayers. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hebrews 10,
25. Not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all more as to see the daily draw nearer.
Amen. The problem with the Christians of these days, if they meet together, instead of them to do what they are there to do, they start gossiping one another. That is why now it's even more dangerous for Christians to meet together than to separate each other. But in the real sense, Christians of old, they meet together all the time to strengthen themselves, to encourage themselves in the word of the Lord. And it is admonished to us today that we should learn this. If we must make it to heaven, the fire must keep on burning. And how would the fire be burning? Iron sharpened iron. It is very, very imperative that Christians meet together to fellowship together, just as we are connected here now, every time, every morning, from all over the world, to hear the word of God, to fellowship with the Father. Very, 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 very important. Amen.
Amen.
All through the week, Christian soldiers are on the battlefield. All through the week, every day, all Christians, if you don't believe it now. All through the week, Christian soldiers are on the battlefield of life. In the battlefield, soldiers often get discouraged, wounded, fearful, or even possibly face the pressure to desert from the battle. Hebrews 3, verse 12. Hebrews 3 verse 12. Please don't go. Just hold on. Hebrews 3 verse 12. One Christian, I'm coming, sir. You read it. Hebrews 3 verse 12. One Christian, that they might have an evil heart or of unbelief in departing from the living God. The solution is daily and weekly accountability with other Christians in the church. In the church, soldiers can receive the encouragement and refreshment they need to continue on as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. That's why it is very good for us to gather every day, because we can be discouraged. We need each other. Not churches you go to, all they think about is how to drink more and drink more. Some woman is the son is doing birthday, will dance and dance and dance. At the end, they bring one man that wants to come and crack joke. No, we are army of the Lord. Satan is fighting us every day. Remember, the Bible told us in Ephesians 6 and 12, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, against principalities and power. We are fighting every day. So people, if they are not encouraged, they'll fall apart. So what do? We need to come together to encourage each other through the word of God. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 12.
Take care, brothers, lest there be in any of you an evil, unbelieving heart, leading you to fall away from the living God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is not their fault. We are armies. There are battles everywhere from all angles. If we leave each other, we'll fall apart. Like soldiers on the other side, if you see soldiers that are fighting, when one is wounded, you see the one that is the one that will come and carry the one at the back. They will keep on running. They never leave each other. That's what we should be doing. That's why this ministry is out for us to encourage each other so that we will not fall apart. And I pray the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen. Yeah.
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3, I read, thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Hallelujah. But you cannot endure it alone. The battle, the heavenly race battle is not a battle for one person, though it's individual race, but we all must run it together. That's why I need you. You need me. We need each other. Iron, sharpen iron. The soldier who fight alone in the battle, we will very soon quit the battle. That's why some people are quitting. Why? Because they have no fire burning around them. No bodies to encourage them. No source of livelihood. No undiluted word of life. For you to be able to live undiluted life, as my sister prayed just now, you must be connected to the source of undiluted word. You must be connected to the source of where they'll be giving you good bullets, grenade bullets, as you will be weighed down. So therefore, let us encourage ourselves. If you don't want to backslide into where we are coming from, we must get connected to the source of the powerhouse every day, which is the source of the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
If you are not sleeping, shout hallelujah.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
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 I hope we are getting it.
Yes,
sir. Right,
sir. Now, the next one is no prayer watch. The next thing that can make a man to backslide is when there's no prayer watch. The Lord Jesus Christ, before he left this world, admonished us. He just instructed his followers to watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. Watch and pray. If there's no prayer watch, remember somebody is watching you. Satan is watching where he will get you down. The only way bro peace can be able to make it to the end is when it's also watching through prayer. Prayer watch is very, very necessary. That's why this ministry is called Mountain of Solution and Redemption Prayer Ministry. We must learn to pray at all times if we will not go down. The lack of prayer watch make many people to backslide. And come again. Jesus instructed his followers to watch and pray. Watch and pray that ye enter in not into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Matthew chapter 26, verse 41. When you get to read it, the key to overcoming temptation is not to enter into it. Don't enter into temptation before you start struggling. Watch so that you will see the temptation coming. It's better you overcome it in a distance that you are wallowing inside of it. Falling into temptation before trying to go out of it is dangerous. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
God help me to learn my voice now. Amen.
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 The spirit is willing, the flesh is weak. The key to overcoming temptation is not to enter in. If we enter into it, we will be overcome by it. By spending time in prayer with God, we are prepared by God to foresee the evil and hide ourselves from it. When you are praying, God will start revealing this to you. And you will see the evil coming from distance. You will run away from it. Amen? Amen. Amen. Let somebody read Proverbs chapter 22, verse 3.
Proverbs 22,
verse 3.
Praise the Lord. Proverbs 22, verse 3, I read. A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, but the simple pass on and have punished. Amen.
Amen. A prudent man, a prayerful man, foreseeth evil from a distance, foreseeth a problem, foreseeth temptation from a distance, and run away from it. But a careless man, a prayerless man, we walk into it and be destroyed by it. So therefore, we are advised to watch and pray. In the prayer, in the Lord's Prayer, we are told to pray. Lead us not into temptation. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Matthew 6, 13, we're going to read it. Through prayer, God alerts our spiritual sensitivity. Through prayer, God alerts our spiritual sensitivity to evil. So that when faced with temptation, we are immediately able to bring out thoughts captive to the obedience of Christ. 2 Corinthians 10, verse 4 and 5. Let's read there. 2 Corinthians 10, 4 and 5.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
2 Corinthians 10, 4, I read. For the weapon of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty to God to the pulling down of strongholds. Verse 5, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted himself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But how can we do this when we are prayerless? How can we do this? How can we cast all this imagination away? We can't do it when we are lukewarm, when we are not prayerful, when we are not watchful. The only way we can be able to do what 2 Corinthians 10, 5, 4 and 5 told us here is when we are prayerful Christians, when we are watching in praying. And I pray the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The next one is pity party because of falling. Pity party because of falling. What do I mean here? When you try to encourage yourself, I don't want to fall. I don't want it to happen. Before you know it, you are falling. I don't want this to happen to me. Our brother Job said, what I fear most has happened to me. The question is not, will the Christian fall? That is not the Christian. Don't be afraid of falling. If you are, maybe you are walking on the street now, and you see the grass slippery, and you are, they fear you, a tendency that you must fall. Because of that shaking, your leg will be unstable to walk, so you fall down. So the question is not, will the Christian fall? The question is, what will be the Christian response when he or she falls? What will be the Christian response? There's no body that is immune against falling, brother. Satan will come and say, hey, man, sister, if you fall now, you are finished forever. If you know it, you'll be living in fear. Living in fear. And if you know it, people say, the Lord have not given you the spirit of fear. That fear is not of God, is torment. And I pray, God will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. The question is not with the Christian fall. The question is, what will the Christian's response be when he falls? Romans chapter 3, verse 23. And Romans 7, 15 to 25. It's a common experience to all Christians at one time or others. Satan is called the accusers of the brethren. Revelation 12, verse 10. Satan uses failure as a club over our head to discourage us and cause us to give up. He tried to convince us that we will never find genuine victory and joy in serving the Lord Jesus Christ. God revealed that a just man falls seven times. Praise Master Jesus. God revealed that a just man, not a sinner now, a just man falls seven times and rises up again. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 16. When there is genuine repentance and confession, God will restore. God will restore the year that the locust has eaten. Joel chapter 2, verse 25. He will give the believer beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, and the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. He will bind, rebuild the old waste places again. Isaiah 61, verse 3 to 4. It's not about falling. But I'm not saying you should go and pray that you should fall. But if you fall, the Lord is able to bring you up again. Don't live in fear when you are serving the Lord. As I illustrated before, when the ground is slippery, before you get there, you're already, can I? Like when you want to cross a bridge, the bridge is tiny. As you face the bridge, you see the bridge, how can I, will I not fall into the river today? My eye, I have a load this thing. My eye will tell me today. Because you are saying it, you will fall into that river. But if you climb the river with boldness, and climb the river with boldness, before you know it, you are at the other side of the bank of the river. So let us not be afraid of falling. Let us face our Christian race with boldness. When you are afraid, I don't follow you. If I fall now, what would I do? You are concentrating on your falling than on your making it to heaven. I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Romans chapter 3, verse 23. Somebody.
Praise the Lord.
Let's see Proverbs 24, verse 16.
Romans 3, verse 23, I read. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Amen.
Amen.
All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible does not say all have sinned and remain a sinner. We all have sinned, but the one the Lord is looking at are the people who get up from their sin and keep on moving. Not those who fall and remain there. We all fall every day. What is falling? Whenever you sin against God, you are falling. So, when you realize that you have sinned, quickly get up, dust yourself. I'm not saying you should just leave yourself to be falling and getting up. No. Do everything to make sure you are walking boldly in this race. That's why it is very good to be hurt. Don't be afraid. If I fall now. When Satan knows your weak point, that you are always afraid of falling, I tell you, you'll bring you down. But when you know that the Lord is strong for you, Jesus is always there to strengthen you. You are not afraid of sin. You are not afraid of those things that will make you fall. I tell you, you are not afraid of fornication. You are not afraid of adultery. You know the Lord is there to strengthen you. You will always overcome. You will walk as overcomer. You'll be going. I'm going out now. May I know fornicate today on the road? If I see a woman today, I don't know if I'll fornicate with her. What is that? Because that you always want to be inside. I'm going to shop now. The spirit of stealing. I don't have it before, but today, if I get there, don't come into my life with spirit of stealing. What is that? Satan know that you are afraid of stealing. If you don't get to that shop today, for you know, even if you don't steal, the thing will enter your pocket by itself. Why? Because you have let Satan know that you are afraid of those things. And I pray the Lord have mercy upon us in Jesus' name. Amen. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 16.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For the righteous fall 7 times and rises again, but the wicked stumble in times of calamity.
Amen. The righteous means the pure, the holy. Fall 7 times. And yet the 7th Spirit of God is there to wake him up again. To raise him up again. Falling is not a problem. But getting up when you are falling. And the Lord will always be there to help us in Jesus' name. Amen. You read Isaiah 61, verse 3 to 4. This, please quickly read it.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I read Isaiah 61, verse 3 to 4. It said, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they may be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that they might be glorified. Verse 4. And they shall build. Amen. Continue.
Yes.
Okay. And they shall build the old waste, and they shall rise up the former desolation, and they shall repair the waste cities and the desolations of many generations. Amen.
Hallelujah. This is the reason the Lord Jesus Christ came. For those who are falling to rise again, they shall build the lost waste places. Where they are falling, the Lord is able to bring them up. To give oil of gladness for mourning. People who were dreadful before one or the other, they are now lamenting. The Lord is able to bring you up. Falling is not a problem. But the problem is we fall. We stretch and say, Lord Jesus! Jesus, deliver me! I never planned for falling. But all of a sudden, I see myself fall. Jesus knows our hearts. He knows that we are doing everything to make sure we are watchful. To make sure we run away from sin. But if peradventure, Satan, as cunning as he is, took you from behind or not to you, the Lord is also there to also pick you up from behind. So therefore, don't be afraid. Jesus, don't be living a pitiable life. Hello. We don't go to hell now. How will I do? How will I survive this? They say planting of hell. They say wearing of this. You lead those things and keep on moving. The Lord who have told you to do it is able to strengthen you. All those pity yourself. Stop it. Be strong. The Lord will take you there in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Next one is pity party because of circumstances. Pity party because of circumstances. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
This one is very tricky. If you want to let you know, Apostle, please, you have been looking for this for some time now. God cannot do it for you anymore. If I even stop preaching myself, God will not be angry. God, it is God that has not done it for me. If God has done it for me, I would have still continued going. You are trying to console yourself the reason why you will not do it again. Pity party. You are making yourself comfortable in your circumstances. Give your circumstances the reason why you should not serve God again. Before you know it, Satan will land you on the ground. Satan tried to convince us that God has put so much upon us. Satan tried to convince us that God has put too much on us. A root of bitterness developed towards God, and we therefore feel justified in giving into sin. Joshua encouraged him to curse God and die. He tried to convince Job that God really didn't care about him, and that his circumstances were more than he should have to bear. God wants Christians to fret. Not desires in any way to do evil. God never put too much on any person. He will not allow us to be to be tempted above that we are able. Job chapter 2, verse 9. Another person, Psalm 37, verse 8. Sister Ego, if you are still there, 1 Corinthians 10:13.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Job 2:9. Then his wife says to him, "Do you still hold fast to your integrity? Curse God and die." Continue.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you want, this woman very well, she had justification to say what she was saying. She was to herself and to the devil that was using her, she was just, please read verse 10.
Praise the Lord. Verse 10. But he said unto her, "Thou speakest as one of the foolish women speaketh. What shall we receive good at the hand of God? Shall we not receive evil? Did not Job sin with his lips?" Amen.
Pastor Jesus.
So, hallelujah.
The wife was trying to tell Job the reason why he must call God, the reason why he must backslide. "This thing is too much for you. You have been in Europe for how many years? You've been preaching, doing everything. All you can account for is two bicycles on the killer there. All you can account for, you don't have documents. You don't have anything. What are you doing? Just carry your bag and be doing what, go and be doing what other people are doing. Go and do those things that is hard to use back, hard to give to people. If you do it two times, money is everywhere. But you know it, if you give me to it, to that cancer of the devil, you will fall." This was what happened to our brother, Brad Job. But thank God for Brad Job. He answered the wife squarely. "Can we receive this and not receive that? You speak as the foolish person that Satan is. Satan is so foolish that we want to let you know, hey, sister, can't you see your life? It's when they ask you, don't wear earring again. Don't paint your hair again. You are not like an old woman. Go and pick them up again and see how beautiful you will be. For you know it, you see that and start, yes, so you're not going to bring your old picture. Hey, I used to be very beautiful. Hey, I used to be a beautiful woman. What has come over me? You'll not be pitying your state now. Instead of you to be rejoicing that you are now the true image of God, you are not cherishing the abundance you used to be before. The life of immorality you used to be before, you have gone back to it again. Just looking at the picture, hey, is this me ego or before? Ego, you used to be very, very wonderful. This you used to be very tall with your high heel. You see all those hair? Those are foolish thoughts that Satan will always bring to our heart. Hey, look at your friend, the person you graduated together in Africa. They are doing well. What are you serving God for? If you go to Africa now, what will you show up for it? But they are forgotten. There's something in you that gather all the money together all over the world, cannot buy it. Satan bled you not to see the real thing, but we see the things that are passing away of this world. Pity party because of circumstances. As Brother Peter will always pray, our circumstances will not take us away from the presence of the Lord in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Some people will disconnect and say, my sister, what happened? Has any of the ministers offended you? Have I offended you? No, man of God. Hey, man of God, no, you are not offended. But what is happening? Why? Hey, man of God, you know, what is that thing that the Lord cannot do for you? You are only in your university of adversity. Very soon, you will be graduate. You'll be a graduate. That circumstance is there to checkmate you. Very soon, the Lord will pull you out of it. Don't backslide because of circumstances. Don't drop your salvation because of situation around you. I pray the Lord will help you, help me, and help us all in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Psalm 37, verse 8.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I read Psalm 37, verse 8. It says, cease from anger and forsake wrath. Fret not thyself in any wise to do evil. Amen.
Yeah. So don't allow any situation to make you transfer aggression on other people. Cease from anger. People, when something happens to them, everybody around them, they're in trouble. No more time again. The last one, fighting rather than fleeing temptation. Fighting temptation rather than fleeing temptation. Twice Paul told Timothy to flee temptation. So the more you fight temptation, the more you give into temptation. For the next minute, try not to think about the number of temptation try not to think about number four, the way I put it here. You will discover that every time you purposely reason into not to think of number four, you are repeatedly thinking of it. What do I mean here? Maybe what you don't like to do, maybe fornication. If you are always thinking about it, hey, I don't want to fall into that sin of fornication. I don't want to fall into it. But you know, when you are sleeping, you see women around you trying to do it, what you don't do in the daytime. Because your heart is filled with them. It's what you are thinking all the time. You are fighting it. Just flee from it and forget about them. You are meditating on them. Even if you don't do it daytime, in the night, Satan will magnify your heart, your spirit man. You see yourself fornicating around in the night. Yes, because sometimes you see yourself doing some things you can never do in the daytime. But most time you picture them your mind. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Please quickly read 1 Timothy chapter 6. Yes, I'm trying to close a little time. I'm against time. 1 Timothy 6, verse 11, and 2 Timothy 2, verse 22.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
1 Timothy 6:11. But thou, O man of God, flee these things and follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, and meekness. Praise the Lord. 2 Timothy 2:22. I read. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Flee also youthful lust, but follow righteousness, faith, charity, peace with them that call on the name on the Lord out of a pure heart. Amen.
Amen. You see how Paul admonished Timothy two times in 1 Timothy and 2 Timothy, flee. So don't try to fight temptation, rather flee temptation, flee fornication, flee stealing, flee from any sin you know that will bring you down. Don't try to enter it and start. I don't fornicate, but you are always with women that are naked. How can you survive that? I don't want to steal. You are always, you always submit yourself into where you will get it. Get into a problem. You are not strong enough. You want to go out and preach to women in prostitute house. You come back born again. You will be surprised. You that want to go and preach, they will be going to preach to you. So flee from sin, that fighting sin. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Good time. We got to read John 8:32, Romans 12:21, and Galatians 5:16. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
But then there are much. This is how far we can go because of time. This kind of eternity, we are still controlled by time. Eternity coming, we'll get to the eternity of God. We'll never be controlled by time again. But nevertheless, if you have any question, please ask before we close. If you don't understand, say, a man of God, I did not get into anything at all. I don't understand. Maybe you will wait behind, you and I will be doing it. Or whatever question you have, just ask. Don't be afraid. Any question? Or maybe contribution. Question or contribution. We are on Bible study. I'm not preaching, as I said before. So when I is preaching, if I preach, it's okay. God bless you. Bye-bye. But this is Bible study. If you have any question, give. If you have any contribution to what you have just said now, you can contribute also. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So no question, no contribution. That means no work done today then. If there's no question, no contribution.
I understand everything, but the last one I didn't get it very well. Fighting temptation rather than I didn't understand it very well.
Fighting temptation rather than flee from it can make you fall into it.
Okay.
You are fighting it instead of to flee from it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
You don't want to fornicate, but you are always in the midst of where women are naked or where men are doing immoral things. You try to struggle, instead of you to flee from them, you enter there and start fighting. Hey, I don't fornicate, but you are there. For you know it before. As I say, fighting temptation rather than being temptation can make you fall. Okay. Don't fight it, you flee from it.
Praise the Lord, sir.
Hallelujah.
So what I'm trying to contribute is that I thank God for your life, sir, for this teaching tonight. Because this teaching has made me, in particular, to know that there are some, lifestyle that we live that we thought is the normal, and you don't even see it as an avenue through which Satan can, cause one to backslide.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them we live with it naturally with this teaching. Our eyes have been opened, attaching value, to things before we might not see it, as one of those things that Satan can use to creep in.
Mm-hmm.
Because the more, and you have made me to know that the more you begin to attach a value to a thing, before you know it, it becomes an idolatry.
Mm-hmm.
It becomes so precious to you. So the teacher has got a long way to let me know some things, in a Christian life that we don't even take notice of them before. But there's those little things like ants that can destroy a whole garden. So I'm very much blessed in this teaching. God will surely bless you in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Now, please, since some people don't have questions, I want to ask a question now. I want to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want Sister Nina to throw more light on little compromise. What do I say about little compromise? Sister Nina. Maybe she was not even there at all. She was sleeping. Amen. Sister Antonio, our boss today, threw light on little compromises.
Little compromise. If you allow little sin into your life, it will get bigger and you will fall without knowing.
Amen. Amen. God bless you, ma'am. Praise the Lord. Sister Antonia Okaka, throw light on neglect of responsibilities. And what do I say about Brother David? Sister Antonia Okaka. Sister Antonia Okaka, she will not be also there. Amen.
Amen.
hidden now?
Yes, Apostle. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You said neglecting the work of God, like maybe you said that if we are connecting, maybe you are connecting like 5 minutes earlier, like early to the time of worship, and gradually you neglect and you start coming late, and you feel that when you start coming late, then you are compromising, you are losing it. And you said that what you spoke about David was when David refused to go to war and he stayed and he refused to go to war and he, I've forgotten the name of the lady that he went, he was...
Mm-hmm. Bathsheba.
Yeah. Bathsheba, yeah. Praise the Lord, sir.
Hallelujah. Sister, so what I'm doing is maybe they not get it where I was preaching. Maybe when they're not doing it with themselves, they will be able to get something. Amen. Amen. Sister Lucy Izeko, true light on deception of neutrality. Sister Lucy Izeko, true light on deception of neutrality.
Big English.
Is she there? Sister Izeko, Esther. Yes, sir.
Hello, sir. Are you following me?
Yes.
Some people are answering from market. Some people are in vacation.
People are sleeping, sir.
Some people are even sleeping. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Wow. This was.
Sister. This sister Esosa, answer the question. I just need to, you know.
Question.
I mean, she was not even with us. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Sister Itoha Obazele, true light on deception of neutrality. If the English is too much, people should tell me the English was too much.
It's not too much.
It's not so much.
Not everybody. It's not too much for you. It may be some people.
What did I say about the first point that I gave of deception of neutrality? When you try to be neutral. Oh. When you try.
Neither here or there.
Okay.
Balancing the world and God.
And when you try to stay on the fence, Sister Itoha, throw more life on it.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, when you try to stay in the fence, as you said, maybe for example, just like the for Job and when he would have told her, are you still keeping your integrity? Cause God and die. He was trying to defend his husband so that he tell the husband, just cause God, you die, then your trouble and your story is finished. But not knowing that he was speaking foolishness.
Are you preaching another topic or what?
Ask you another question. Maybe I don't get this one.
You see, students. Prophet, you see, I'm the spirit for you. What I'm doing tonight.
In fact, you, God will bless you, my spirit. Amen. We will not know about it. My spirit.
The Lord.
Yeah.
So, second now, I give you another chance. What do I say about deception of neutrality?
Yeah, Apostle, this is very number one. This is number one. Are you reading?
Yes.
That was the question I want to ask. I didn't really write anything. Only that number one did not write. So it was in my mind I would ask the deception of, I don't know what is the last word.
The question I threw to you was actually your question to me.
Yeah, I have no idea about this number one. Honestly.
Praise the Lord.
Enough.
Hallelujah. Can I say something?
Wait now, wait, please. I have a question. It's Isaiah. Read James 4, verse 4. Maybe from there you get the answer.
The friend of this world is an enemy with God.
Mm-hmm.
James 4, verse 4 said, ye adulterers and adulteress, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with God? Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is the enmity of God.
Mm-hmm. Now compare it with Matthew 2, verse 30.
Matthew what, sir?
Matthew 12, 30.
Matthew 12.
Are you listening?
Yes.
Matthew 12, 30.
Matthew 12, 30 or 20.
30.
Okay. He that is not with me is against me. And he that gathereth not with me is scattereth abroad.
Amen. Summarize now.
I should summarize. So okay. This James 4 is talking about adulterer and adulteress, that they are enemy of God. He said, adulterers and adulteress, know you know that they are friendship of the world, enemy with God. Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is enemy. So the enemy of God, whoever that made a friend with them, they are also enemy of God. So this 12:30 is talking about that he that is not with me is against me. It's almost the same. If you are not with God, you are against God. If I just say, for the man of God is preaching the word of God, please, I don't like this message. I don't like it. You are against God. But if revelation comes, it's a lie, it's not correct. You are against God. Anybody that is against God is enemy of God.
Now you are not against God, you are not against the world, you are trying to maintain a neutral ground. What are you doing?
I'm not against God, I'm not of the world.
Lukewarm, cold or hot.
So the Lord Jesus said, I will speak the person out of his mouth.
Revelation 3:16.
Hallelujah. Like, did they ask or don't ask?
I wonder. Hey. We didn't have
Hallelujah.
Praise
God. He's trying to help my sister. Amen.
Amen.
The session of interacting is when you try to be neutral. When you say, I don't hate Christianity. I'm not a Muslim, I'm not a Christian, I'm just who I am. Actually, you are against God, you are against yourself, you are against everything. Such people, you will go to hell. If you don't like Apostle Manuel, you don't like, I don't like Fred, I don't like Apostle Manuel, I'm just like that. And it's, I don't hate him, I don't love him. You hate me. One of the day. You are not with me, you are against me. So, that is it. Amen?
Amen.
I hope we are not agree, we are having some little time.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'm not angry.
Revision. Amen. It's revision. Amen. Amen. Sister Clarice, what was your question?
I had an idea on neutrality. The central of neutrality. That's what I wanted to say.
Okay, not an idea, but it's the same idea I have, okay? I hope I'm right.
Yes, Pastor.
Amen. Now,
little compromises. Number two, throw light on it. Now, what do I say about Sons of Solomon? 2:15. Sister Gloria, okay, brother. You can throw light. Or Sister Richard, Gabriel. We need light on it. Little compromises. Can mix with the light. What do I say about that? Sister Elizabeth Ogigo.
Yeah, praise the Lord.
Who is answering? Who is talking?
Gloria Kwebali.
Okay, carry on.
Like on my own way, I don't know, sir. But like what I understand, this little compromise is for example, when the word of God, as the Lord said, we should not be putting on trousers, for example, now, and when you are going to work, maybe you are going to work. And where you are walking, they put on only trouser. Then you will now say, oh, let me just wear trouser inside the walking premises there. Then when I close, then I can put it inside put back the trouser in the pocket, in the tasche. Then I go home with skirts. I think there you are compromising.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, Sister Wigo, you have contribution there. Sister Elizabeth.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The way I understand it is that you said don't allow little sin in your life, you know. By the time you entertain a little sin,
you may think that this is just little, but gradually it will now lead to a bigger one, you know, which can, you know, cause backsliding. Praise the Lord. Maybe for example, you used to read your Bible maybe for an hour, you know. Now you start to read it for 30 minutes. Before you know it, you won't even have time to read your Bible. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Again, an illustration about a rock. How do you know? Sister Astrid. What do I talk? I made mention of rock and something. And I say, if case not taken, a time is coming. Can you reiterate that illustration?
Can Apostle please repeat the question, please?
In this little compromises, I use rock with something to make example. What was that thing I used? How did I use rock to make example today?
I don't understand exactly because I don't know the English so good. But what I understand about the compromise is if you go somewhere where people are doing things, like example, you go somewhere where people are smoking, you say, oh, I'm not smoking, but you are between people who are smoking. But because you are there, you're going to compromise and then still you're going to smoke. You're going to say, oh, let me try. That is what I understand.
Wonderful. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Can you give us the illustration I made today?
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Sister Gloria, you have spoken well. Maybe Sister Etona now want to bring back what she could not do before. Sister Gloria, let's try.
Yeah, praise the Lord. What I heard you said was, you said when a water is falling upon a rock, you just give the rock a little time. Maybe, for example, you went there, maybe the water is falling on the rock. You, after 2 days, you went there, nothing will happen to the rock, but just give that rock maybe 1 year before you know the rock will collapse.
Amen. little drop
of water, this mighty ocean.
Hallelujah. Sister Abiola, you have a question. We'll soon be closed now. We'll soon be closed now, right now.
Yes, sir. So I wanted to ask some questions about number five. You said on neglect of separation from the world.
Yeah.
And you said we read Psalm 1, verse 1 and Proverbs on James 1:27. Yeah. And you said we have to keep ourselves unspotted.
Yeah.
That we couldn't find any stain on us.
Yeah.
So my question, sir, is if you go to a church, sir, that wear jeans, they wear jewelry, like some members wear jeans, they wear jewelry, and things that God doesn't want us to do, sir.
Yeah.
Are you that don't wear those things, sir?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have, like, if you worship with them, if you worship with them and everything, sir, and pray, do you have spots on your garment? Like, is there any spot that can that make you spotless if you go there with a neutral heart? And everything. And you also said to, like, in the deception of neutralism, we shouldn't be we should fellowship with our brethren, sir. We shouldn't be equally yoked with unbelievers.
Yeah.
Like in that kind of case, sir, like when you go to churches like that, are you fellowshipping with unbelievers? And is God there among is God there in the church? Or you yourself, you are neutral, you don't wear all those things.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Who among us can help?
I can help.
Brother.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
From my understanding, Stabiela, the Bible says that separate yourself. I mean, the way I personally understand it, like, the Bible says, what has light got to do with darkness? In other words, when you go to the assembly of people whereby you believe in, you know very well that putting on of all this worldly stuff, Jesus says, no, do not do it. Now, you now say because you are fellowshipping, you go to a church whereby, let's say, maybe 60% of them, they put on all of those demonic satanic things, and let's say 40% of them do not put on those things. But if Jesus Christ should come at that very point in time, from my own understanding, I think those that do not put on those things would be consumed. That's my own understanding. They might get into trouble with Jesus. I mean, in the first place, why do I want to go there anyway? Because Jesus said, do not go there. Separate yourselves from them. You have to look for where they obey the word of God, where Jesus says, do not put on those things. And that is where you want to go. But if I find myself going to where they still put on all those things and all that, if rapture should happen, from my understanding, I think I might get into trouble with Jesus with all of this. Those people. That's what I think personally.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because first of all, I want to say this, Sister Abiola. Like now, we have our physical church in England, the UK, and in Nigeria right now. The first thing you ask yourself, first of all, it's not about the people there. It's about the preacher. It's about the person preaching. Do they preach about it? Now, there's no way I can put a gate man on the gate and say, if anybody's coming, a woman that's coming with trousers, put the trousers away from her. Or put the earring away. What matters is the word being preached there. Are they hammering on the same? Some people might be defiant. Some people might not want to listen. It's not on the right of the pastor to say, get out. If you don't want to pull hearing away, leave the church. Go. Now, the most important thing is the foundation. Is the man on the altar? Is he preaching it? If he's not preaching it, you have no right to be there. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If the man on the altar is not preaching about sin, he's not hammering it, you see the people there, you can run away. But if the man is sincerely crying about it every day, maybe 40% is keeping it, 60% is not keeping it, go with the 40 and keep praying. But if you not get there,
that even the members are keeping it, but the force is not coming from the altar. Run away from that place. Maybe now the issue of hair, football, all these things. You go to a place, the pastors are saying it does not matter. You see some members are saying, hey, we know this is a sin. But the pastor will bring the fire from the altar to burn the spirit in the heart of men away. He's not doing it. Sister, run away. That is the place of the ungodly. But if the message is there, the true message is there, it's sometimes it's not so easy for even on this mountain right now. If God opened our eye to see people who are keeping it, what you are preaching, maybe 40 out of 60. Maybe it can be everybody. As we are talking right now, some women can be put on pyjama to sleep tonight, trouser. Some women can be on earring right now. But the most important thing is the message coming. It's the message that the Lord will hold people responsible for on the last day. I don't know if you're getting it, ma'am.
Yes, sir. I am, sir.
So, the first thing is, what is the message there? Go for the message. Go for the source of the message. If the message is not coming, run away. Yes. The message there will contaminate you. The 40% that are doing there, they may be polluted also. So, that is it. Amen.
Amen.
So, because I will stop here, and the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. So, I want somebody who wrote that to quickly tell us from Pat Indide. I want you to ask questions today. You didn't even ask me that one. I asked to read Bible today again. We're not there. From deception of neutrality to the last one, fighting rather than fleeing temptation. I want to give all the points from one to the end. Is that part needed?
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. The way I understand everything is that
I did say you should summarize. Name each one by one. My friend, I'm not saying go and give her your book.
I'm not in the same place. I'm in the dining, she's upstairs.
Amen. Amen. I want you to outline it one by one. Deception or neutrality. Just like that. Name them.
When people
we have about two,
I should name it one. Okay, number one, deception. The second one, little compromise. The third one, neglect of responsibility. The fourth one, temporal value. The fifth one, temporal value. The fourth one, the fifth one, neglect, separation from the world. The sixth one, reformed without transforming.
Good. Stop there.
The seventh one.
It's okay. Praise the Lord. You have tried. Sister Precious Apamu. Continue from there.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Number 7, neglect of godly fellowship. Number 8, no prayer watch.
Praise the Lord.
Number 9.
Wait. Okay. You have tried. Amen.
Amen.
Ifeoma Ogbuzo. Ifeoma Ogbuzo. Okay, she's isn't there. Amen.
Amen.
Sister Jennifer. Sister Jennifer. Okay. Sister Clara, Attorney.
Number 7, neglect of Christian fellowship. Number 8, no prayer. Number 9, pity party. Number 10, pity party because of circumstances.
The first one is pity party because of what?
Pity party, I didn't get it right because my brother was disturbed.
Because of falling.
Because of failure. Sorry, I missed it there. Because of failure.
Okay.
Amen. Yeah, okay, you have tried. Stop it there. Sister Pat. You are there. She's not there. Sapat, the sister with a red handbag. Amen. Okay, she's not there. Sister Clara. Clara, US.
Hallelujah, sir.
Amen. The last one.
Fighting temptations rather than fleeing temptation.
Amen. Praise the Lord. So please, when we are coming, always come with paper and a pen so you can write something down. So after the study, you can also go and study again as the Christian, the Berean Christian. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. We have heard the word of God.
Sir, you said pity party because of circumstances. You said something like that, so I'm surprised you changed.
Yes. I did change it, still remain the same.
Because somebody said you say it's not correct, that's what I'm saying.
It's too pity party. The circumstances are failure.
Yeah, same thing. Because of circumstances, they strike or failure.
Number one is a pity party because of failure, and the other one is pity
number
party.
Number 9.
9 and 10.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So please, there, you're not born again. Please give your life to Jesus Christ. Say after me, say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. I've decided today to come out of sin, to embrace you, and arm and be like your children that you are nurturing to come to you on the last day. Have mercy upon me for staying with the world for so long. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. Today, I renounce the devil and all that concern him. I accept you, Lord Jesus Christ, as my Lord and personal Savior. Come into my life, come and dwell in me. I receive power today to go and sin no more. I am born again, old things have passed away, and all things have become new. Thank you, Jesus Christ, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name, amen. I pray with you if you have declared this declaration because Christ is rejoicing right now. Father, I thank you for this one. Thank you for the Bible study today. Thank you for the way you have dealt with us. Thank you for this one that have come out of sin. I pray for grace. I pray for strength. I pray that this world will not be used against them, nor against any of us on the last day. Rather, we all shall dance and rejoice in heaven to declare to you and to ourselves how we overcome in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Abba, amen. Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Also to pray for yourself and say, ask the Lord to do something in your life, whatever to make you backslide. This world will not be against you. Pray that God will strengthen you, empower you, and give you more insight of his word. In Jesus' name, let us pray.
Lord, I cry for mercy. Help me, Lord, empower you to use the Lord. My Lord and my Father, help me, Lord, to stand against me at the last day, Lord. Stand against me at the last day, Lord. Stand against me at the last day, Lord. My Lord, if I have my power, also, Lord. Also,
Jesus, for us, Lord, in the name of Jesus, please have mercy.
Most importantly, we're going to pray and say, Father, give us the grace to watch and pray. The devil has killed many people out of prayer. Many people cannot pray anymore because of what the other one said. Father, every power assigned to kill my urge of prayer, let that power be, Father, plant that seed of prayer in my life again. Make me hot in my prayer altar again. In the name of Jesus, let us pray.
Father, Lord, God, help me for my spiritual life to be strong. Lord, Father,
Father, we thank you, we bless you, we worship you, exalt your name. We thank you, Father. You've done again tonight. Thank you for using me. I'm grateful, Father. Just declare that I am, Father. I know nothing but you alone, Father. I have the privilege to teach again tonight. I say thank you for using me. I thank you for those you allow to listen tonight. I'm grateful that God, in nothing person like me, Father, you allow people all over the world to connect to hear their voice. I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful. Thank you for their life. So God, I pray this word will not be used against me nor against any of us on this mountain in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You, Father, because on the last day we all joyfully come to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. It's offering time.
Bless the time.
Give us the grace to follow, abundant grace to follow. We need your grace to follow. Your grace is enough for us. Give us that grace to follow. Abundant grace to follow. We need your grace to
follow.
Yeah.